I'm part of the Fluid Interfaces group, which work on human augmentation and think about the way that computer can fluidly integrate with the human body. And that's sort of like the theme of our research group. And my work particularly look at wearable technology, right? Technology that put on the human body that can augment our kind of capability and enhance our ability to do different things. Right now, the lab turned off the light during the night. So it's kind of, you know, make me really sad because all the time I usually see like the building lit up and see research activity, people walking around, and it's kind of interesting when you see that, you know, completely, you know, empty and silent and dark. One thing that my advisor, Patty, advised me is, you know, to walk around once, you know, a couple of hours to get some inspiration and, you know, just to do something, you know, not just like being on the Zoom call or on the email all the time. After I walk around this sort of like MIT campus, I start to look for sort of like unusual spot, like spot that I never take picture of before. And I start to like juxtapose thing. And that's sort of like my new kind of fun thing to do, like look for places on campus that's sort of like hidden. I never know that was this straight before or like is it always kind of like this? You know, like this little detail that you notice when you don't see people around is kind of interesting. This is like a sanctuary. We are at the Great Dome of MIT, right? So like the iconic building. If you look up, you see the name of like the great scientists and philosophy and inventor and people that have like contributed to society. And we sort of like have that name in the stone. And I think that's one of the reasons I think this is like a sanctuary. Not because it's like quiet and peaceful, but it's also symbolized preservation of like human knowledge and the great thing that human had done to society and the world. I try to relax and, you know, take time off and stuff, but with everything that's going on, like things change so much every day. I don't think we can really relax. Like, you know, one day, you know, policy is like to kick, you know, international student out. Another is like, oh, we have the second outbreak, or, you know, like there's so many things that's going on. So I don't even know how to relax and just put, you know, our mind at ease because things are just changing and so dynamic. Or what is really unique about being a student in this period? There's so much responsibility that you feel like you have. Like you are supposed to be learning new things and you need to think about what the future gonna look like. You know, if this is gonna be my new normal, like am I gonna live like this? Like is post-apocalyptic supposed to be sort of like a thing now? And because when you are uncertain about the future, it makes the future a little bit, you know, grim and a little bit sad. And you know, you're gonna live in this world for a long, long time. So now you start to see what that might look like. You know, at MIT, there's a saying that, you know, that we need to rise to the challenge. And right now, the challenge is actually like in front of us right now. I think it's really interesting to think about what is our role, why we are still learning, you know, try to make sense of this world, what is actually our contribution to this.